Hey, what's going on, guys? Joe Not So Slim Picking here. Saturday, almost afternoon. Doing some yard sales, and I actually went yard selling already. My wife was with me, so I didn't film an intro. I'm kind of doing the intro now. But I'm going back to a yard sale that I was already at to buy some stuff that I've never bought before. So stay tuned and see, but I think I have potential to make a pretty good amount of money. So we're getting started here at the first yard sale, and sorry for that terrible intro because, like I mentioned, my wife was with me today doing these yard sales, and she did not want to be on camera, so I didn't film my intro in the car like usual, but that's okay. It still works. But right away, I noticed with this yard sale, see all those green caps down there? You've got laundry detergent all over the place. This is a couponer's type of yard sale. They get a bunch of stuff, they coupon and get a bunch of stuff for super, super cheap, and then try to resell it or resell it at yard sales. I can almost guarantee you I never really find much to resell at this type of sale. We did end up finding some laundry detergent, though, that my wife wanted to pick up for $10, which is normally around $25. So I found a good deal there, but definitely not going to resell it. Next sale here. This one was actually pretty decent, but again, I wouldn't say this person was like a coupon person, but they had a lot of stuff that you could tell was Walmart clearance. So occasionally I buy stuff from Walmart clearance too, to resell, if I can find something good enough to make a decent profit. But here I'm looking at these tumblers, and they all said, like, I don't know, was it Ravenclaw, Hufflepuff? I think they were Harry Potter type of tumblers is what I'm trying to say. But looked them up online. The sell-through rate really wasn't that good. They were nice tumblers, but they were asking too much. I think somewhere around $7 a tumbler. And I thought, well, I'm not even going to bother trying to get it down lower than that. So decided to skip it. Over here, just some other toys. I was looking up this Spy Kids kind of thing. It was some type of spy gear or whatever. But again, didn't find much there. Didn't really go for much on eBay. So I eventually decided to put it down and not to get it. I do get asked occasionally if I feel bad or worried about scanning items at a yard sale. And when I first started, I kind of used to, but I really got over that pretty quickly. I don't really care. If somebody wants to ask me why I'm scanning something or what I'm doing, I'm just honest about it. So I'm really not doing anything wrong or what, but I'm just looking for a good deal, that's all. So I ended up picking up a few of these Marvel action figure characters. I forgot that fellow's name, but I'll explain those in a second. But they also had different, like I said, there's Walmart clearance tags all over this stuff. These Chicago Bears license plate frames, they can do okay. And then these are like Chicago Bears leaf bags, so they probably picked up a whole bunch of these for super cheap. But I'm checking the comps on them, and they really aren't going for too much at all. They wanted $7 for the license plate frames, and I would pay maybe $1 for those a piece, but I wasn't even going to ask, see if they'd go that low. I decided to pass.
I didn't find too much in this sale. I got a couple of these action figures. Packages kind of tore up, so, but they're half off on everything. So I got both of these for $3, so $1.50 each.
This was actually a nice little sale. This family, they had two racks of clothes on each side of the driveway. And most of them were women's clothes. But I always look through these and just kind of pick through anything that stands out that's unique or unique design or looks vintage or old. I always look them up. And there's a couple of these sweaters. If you can see there, that sold on eBay, I think it was $19.99. And I'll ask them for a price here in a second. This brand was something Unicorn, and it's escaping me at the moment, but I figured if I can get them cheap enough going into winter, that'll go pretty good. Ah, yes, the high school yearbooks from the 60s. Sometimes these can go for a little bit. Sometimes people lose theirs and are looking for their other ones. So I'll pick them up cheap if I can, see if I can flip them.
What are you asking on your it's like sweaters and over here?
$4 on the sweaters, $3 on the shirts. And
okay.
It's a two-piece.
Yeah.
Pants and it's $6.
Okay. And how about your yearbooks right here?
I don't know. Make me an offer.
Oh boy.
Make me an offer.
So you said $4 on a sweater?
Yeah, $4 okay. on the big sweaters and like shawls.
All right.
$3 on the shirts.
If you. I got, how about two sweaters and both those books? I'd give you 10.
Two sweaters?
Yeah.
Okay, two sweaters. That's $8.
Yeah.
You want these two books?
Yeah.
Look at them.
Right.
I mean, if you're interested, we might do four.
Yeah, I'm
I usually try to work with people that buy his own.
Sure. Here,
but.
Yeah, let me check out your. I saw some. These rackets here, those aren't bad. Need some grips on them.
Yeah, so them rackets take 50 cents a piece when we take all of them.
Oh, man.
You know you need them.
Yeah. How about, I'll take, if you want to do 50 cents, well, I'll take two of them off your hands. All so right, for a dollar, and then right. You do the Crocs, we'll do five. You said four on the Crocs?
Where?
50 cents and 50 cents, I'd make it five.
Yeah.
You wanna do that?
$5, okay.
Alright. Oh, you gotta bust my tent again. Alright guys, so we got some Crocs. Look to be pretty much new. Got those for $4. These rackets, I think they're tennis rackets. Grips are pretty bad, but got those for 50 cents each. And then a buck each on the yearbooks, and $4 each for these sweaters. They sell for about $20 each. I think about $15 each for a racket. Those Crocs might be able to get $20, so we'll see. Holy glassware and old art. Got it. So. Hello. Good. No, yeah. So this is the sale that I was kind of alluding to at the beginning. Guys, I don't know a ton about vintage glassware or vintage lamps, but I do know that some of them go for a lot of money. So as I mentioned, I was kind of shooting at the hip here. I actually left my phone in the car and I'm recording with my glasses as I do normally. But I know some of these lamps can go for something. I keep looking at them and I'm thinking, wow, there's just a ton of stuff. Apparently, this gentleman, I overheard a conversation and lost both his parents. Sorry to hear that, but they were avid collectors of some old glassware lamps, and there was a ton of art over there, and I didn't even hardly look at the art. Probably should have spent more time over there. But again, I'm looking at all these things, and some of you guys watching these videos, you might be able to pick some things out and notice things better than I would. And if you do, please so let me know and let others know, what did I miss? But you'll see later on, I did come back and pick up some lamps, but as I mentioned, there's a ton of glassware, different stuff here that I didn't know anything about. These little pitchers and water stations or whatever you call them, they're probably worth something. I did pick up this old Gremlin book. He wanted a quarter for it. He ended up giving it to me for nothing, so went ahead and got that. It's a pretty good sign when I got to bring my own boxes. He's probably going to love to see me. So as I mentioned, I really live right around the corner from this sale. I went home, looked up a whole bunch of them on eBay, and at the very least, a lot of these lamps go for like $20 to $30 without the shade.
but on the high end, they can be $100, $200, or even more. And so for me, I'm thinking I'm going to take a little bit of money back and see if he can give me a deal, because he was asking $3 a piece. And I think I end up buying 11 or 12 for $33. So not too bad at all. And again, I might be sitting on these for a while, but it's just the gamble in me. I had to go back and pick up some, list them and clean them up a little bit and see what we can do. I mean, if I sell two of them, they'll double my money and I'll be perfectly happy with that. So here you can see I'm just kind of looking at them, looking for any imperfections, and just trying to pick out which ones look the best, which ones look old, and the ones that are in really good condition.
All right, so we're back at the house here. I end up picking up a total of 11 vintage lamps for, what did I pay? $33. Well, I guess if you count this, $36. And, but a lot of them are these like hand-painted. I think they're hand-painted. But some of these can go for about $50 each, all the way up to $200 or even more. I mean, some of these, can't really get them out of the box now. It doesn't really do it justice, but look at these. I don't know. I ended up buying this one first, and I went back for them all, like I said. So I got a feeling I'm going to make some pretty good money on it. Let me show you the other ones. Not much lighting here, but look at that. Look how pretty that is. Of course, I got to test them, work them, make sure they clean up. But I bought the ones that were in pretty good shape. And, I mean, those are freaking nice. I'll show you some comps so I can see online what they go for. But, yeah, I'm hoping these are going to do pretty good, guys. Thanks for watching.